This is 15mm OSB material. These panels are 40cm by 120cm. I had them pre-cut to size in the lumberyard. These corner clamps help to keep things in place while gluing and nailing the panels together. Here I check that everything is square. The back panel was too large to fit in my car, so I had it cut into two pieces. I also bought it a bit larger because I hadn't decided the final dimensions of the cabinet at that point. And here I add the second piece. A wet rag to wipe off the excess glue can save you some time from sanding. At this point, the cabinet was strong enough to start adding the screws. First, I pre-drilled pilot holes, then I countersunk them, and finally I added the screws. In some cases, I had to mark the position of the screws. I decided to keep this piece because it can protect items from falling off, but this side had to go. I secured my guide rail with a couple of screws. And I used the circular saw to cut off the excess material. Then I cut this small piece with a handsaw, added a flush trim bit on my router, and I flush trimmed the edge. At this point, I screwed the casters in place, mostly to be able to work more freely in my small shop. I might have to remove these in future and add more heavy-duty ones. The screws I added was longer than needed, so I trimmed them flush with the angle grinder. And so far, so good. Next step, cutting the shelves to size. That was not the safest crosscut, so use your circular saw if you don't feel comfortable with the table saw. I wanted them to fit loosely. These are supports for the shelves. You can use a scrap piece as a spacer in order to glue and nail all the supports evenly. 1, 2, 3 supports. At this point, you can add screws for extra strength. This piece acts as a vertical support for the shelves. Here I cut grooves so the shelves can fit in. I hope this piece will keep the shelves straight. So this is the main body of my cabinet. Time to cut the doors to size. You can clamp them together and use a circular saw to cut them both at the same time. The guide rail is really helpful in this kind of stuff. I wanted to attach the doors with piano hinges, so I glue and nail this piece in order to have more meat for the hinges. I supported the door with my foot, added two temporary nails and a clamp to keep it in place. Here I cut the hinge to size. I installed one screw up and one down. Then I start adding screws in a zigzag pattern. Time to pull out the nails I added earlier. Keeping analogies make your design look nicer, so I will make the latch 2 times wider than this piece. The latch is pretty simple to make. Here I trim the screw of the latch flush. And it works. I gave everything a rough sanding with a grinder. Basically, I just removed the sharp edges and fixed some imperfections. And here I blow the dust away. And that's it. Over the past months, I have accumulated many new tools and my small shop looks really messy. This cabinet will help me keep things out of my way while I work. I hope you'll find this project useful. See you soon with a new project video.